Hey everybody, welcome to Improv FAQ. I'm James Quesada, and in this episode, we're going to talk about some things that you can do to get better at improv in addition to taking classes. A lot of students start taking improv classes and end up getting hooked and ask, what else can I do? How can I get really good at this as quickly as possible? And first of all, if you want to get really good at improv and you feel like classes aren't enough, you are right. So in this video, we'll talk about some things that you can do and should do beyond taking classes to get real good at improv. So before we jump into our list, I feel like it's really important to understand why it is that classes aren't enough by themselves. Improv programs are generally 4 to 8 classes in total, and each class is typically 8 weeks long, meeting once a week for 3 hours. And depending on the size of the class, you're only going to spend a fraction of that time on your feet implementing the things that you're learning. And this really misrepresents the learning curve of improv. If you were to try and learn to play an instrument or to dance, it would be unreasonable to think that by the end of a year or two of taking group classes once a week for 3 hours, that you would have anything more than a basic proficiency. In order to end up at an intermediate or advanced level, you'd have to practice and study in between classes and find ways to apply what you're learning. Now, for improv, I feel like the reason it tends to be treated differently from learning other performing arts is because there isn't the same mechanical skills like there are in other disciplines. And what I mean by that is that your body is not automatically equipped to just get up and do ballet. Your hands don't know how to just pick up a guitar and start shredding, but you do have everything you need to just get on your feet and improvise. There are some hard skills involved in improvising, like the mechanics of a game or a form, and also basic theater skills, object work or pantomime, and acting technique, which really don't get enough attention in improv classes, and we'll talk more about that later. But even if you take those skills aside, it doesn't mean that you can just learn how improv is done and then be good at it. Is it easy to learn? Yes. Easy to do? No. Think about meditation, which is mechanically very simple, but just because you know how to do it doesn't mean it won't take you years of practice or even a lifetime to get really good at it. Okay, so let's crack into this list. These are some things you can do to get better at improv beyond taking classes. Number one, read up, listen up. There are so many great books and podcasts and other resources on improv. There's really no excuse to go without them. If you're deep enough into improv to be watching this video and you're doing long form improv, I recommend reading Mick Napier's Behind the Scenes. I will say this a million times. If every long form improviser read this book today, by tomorrow there would be twice as many good shows and half as many bad ones. If you're not in the long form or you want other recommendations, check out my previous video on improv books and resources for a full list of books and podcasts and websites and other resources that I recommend. Number two, see improv shows. Improv is an art form that you can learn from by watching. As an audience member of an improv show, you know as much or as little as the performers do as the show unfolds. So it's super helpful to watch and follow along with the choices that the players on stage are making in real time. Seeing other people's playing styles is also helpful. Seeing examples of when rules are broken and followed and whether that helped or hurt the scene is really great. And also learning the mechanics of an improv show can be really clunky, and seeing a show where the players are using those mechanics seamlessly goes a long way. Number three, go to improv jams. A jam is an improv show where people can sign up to get on stage and play. It's kind of like an open mic or karaoke or a fight club. Jams are great for just getting up and doing improv with a mix of people with different experience levels and playing styles. It's a very supportive and low stakes setting too, because everyone is there to just play with each other. Most improv theaters are gonna have a jam on their show schedule, so if you're taking classes, ask your teacher about jams. Number four, start a practice group or an indie team. If you're in a class and you want to do some extra practice on the things that you're learning, chances are there's a couple other people in the class who would also like that. So get those people together, find a time and a rehearsal space and an experienced improviser or teacher who can coach you, and you've got yourself a practice group. If it involves everyone in your class, great. Some people in your class, cool. If there's not enough people in your class to make it work, go to jams, go to class shows, find enough people to make it work. Number five, take a non-improv theater class. I mentioned this earlier, that the basic theater skills like cheating out to the audience or projecting, acting technique, are not given enough attention in improv classes. And that's true. If you don't have any experience in theater or performance, a basic acting or theater class can be extremely helpful in giving you confidence on stage. Even if you're already feeling comfortable on stage, taking an acting class can help a ton. Working with scripted material removes the burden of creating dialogue and story and helps you zero in on emotion and nonverbal communication and acting. If you find a workshop in clown, mime, ensemble movement, really any form of physical theater, there are incredibly valuable and transferable skills to improv in those disciplines, and taking those types of workshops can bring a whole new dimension to your performance. Number six, and this last one is probably just good advice in general, which is to live an observant life. People watch, study the nuances of your environment, try to imagine what people might be thinking based on their body language, but don't be creepy. Really listen and be present in conversations. Train yourself to be where you are with the people that you're with. It can be pretty challenging to give your full attention to any given thing at any given moment, but if you actively work on that sort of thing, you'll be more able to be in the moment on stage and connect with the people that are on stage with you and with the rest of the room. And guess what? It works both ways. Good improv skills are good life skills, and good life skills are good improv skills. So there you have it. A list of things that you can do beyond classes that will help you get better at improv. Just keep in mind that improv has an endless learning curve, so it's best to be patient and make sure you're enjoying yourself along the way. That's it for this episode. Be sure to like and subscribe. Let me know in the comments if you have any follow-up questions on this topic or if you have suggestions for other questions that I can answer on Improv FAQ.